Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I am Denmar Caranas, a postgraduate medical intern, and I basically provide informative videos to medical students, and I would like to give aspiring Filipino physicians an idea of what a med student usually talk about in med school. If you find this video helpful, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell to be updated for my new videos. For today, we'll be discussing the CPC of Guillain-Barré syndrome, or GBS. GBS is a rare neurological disorder in which the body's immune system mistakenly attacks parts of its peripheral nervous system. And these are the nerves located outside the brain and spinal cord. This can range from mild case to severe cases wherein there is a devastating paralysis enabling the person to breathe independently. And however, the patients with this condition mostly recover. And after recovery, some people will continue to have some degree of weakness. That's why it is important for us to understand the mechanism by which this condition happens so that we could manage our patient well. So this is the overview of our CPC, and we'll be discussing this by section. As for the associated conditions to DAS syndrome, this include minor triggers such as surgery, trauma, bone marrow transplant. All of this have an unknown mechanism for it to induce an immune-mediated damage to the peripheral nerves. However, as for the infections that can happen 1 to 3 weeks prior GBS, these include gastrointestinal or respiratory pathogens like Campylobacter jejuni, CMV, HIV, and EBV. All of them can have a molecular mimicry mechanism by which the gangliocyte antigen present in the peripheral nerves and in the pathogen surface coat, they would trigger the immune system to attack also the peripheral nerves because they resemble it very well. This now would lead to demyelination and trigger the acute inflammatory demyelinating polyneuropathy. And this now would produce motor deficits, which is classic to GBS, the ascending paralysis starting from the legs, the sensory deficits of pain and paresthesias, and also the universal areflexia. Also, there could be a dysautonomia, which is life-threatening, orthostatic hypotension, tachycardia, dysrhythmias, and even urinary retention. As for the nerve damage, when the phrenic nerve is damaged, that would lead to diaphragm paralysis. And as for the cranial nerves, the oculomotor weakness involving the cranial nerve 3, 4, and 6, and then bulbar palsy involving the cranial nerves 9, 10, 11, and 12. This now would cause an difficulty of expectorating discharges, and also it could trigger an aspiration pneumonia, further aggravating the respiratory failure brought about by the paralysis of the diaphragm. And all of these signs and symptoms would constitute the Guillain-Barré syndrome. This now is the reference of my discussion, the 28th edition Harrison's Principles of Internal Medicine. And if you want specific details and further discussion for this, I advise that you read from this book. I would like to leave you with this message. Accept how life happens to be how it is and focus more on what you can change for the better. Thank you for listening and have a good day.